From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. And hello, Savannah, and hello, Georgia. We love Georgia. It's great to be back in this beautiful state with thousands of proud, hardworking American patriots. That's what you are, American patriots. And think of this, 42 days from now, we are going to win the state of Georgia. We are going to defeat Comrade Kamala Harris. And we are going to make America great again. But we're here today to talk about how we're going to launch a historic buildup of American manufacturing muscle and might. This is not a rally, although it feels like a rally. It's really a little event with my 5,000 or 6,000 closest friends in the whole world. But Georgia and Savannah are going to be right in the center of the action. We're going to rebuild our manufacturing, and it's going to happen. It's going to happen fast and beautifully. For years, Americans have watched as our country was stripped of jobs and wealth, and our companies were sold off to foreign countries. You've been watching, and it's been a horror show. I've been watching for many years, and we had it stemmed. And then all of a sudden, bad things happened. Bad things happened, but boy, I'll tell you, we had it stemmed. If we would have had 4 more years, everything, this would be such a different country right now. We would have had no inflation. You wouldn't have Russia attacking Ukraine. You wouldn't have had October 7th with Israel. The Middle East is blowing up. We could be very close to World War III with these characters that don't have any idea what they're doing. But what a shame. In Afghanistan, what a disaster. That was the most embarrassing day in the history of our country, I believe. But GE appliances were sold to the Chinese. IBM computers were again sold to China. Under Kamala Harris, U.S. Steel is now being sold to Japan. I will stop it. We got to do fast. We got to work fast, but we're not going to let it happen. We're not going to let U.S. Steel. 70 years ago, the greatest company on earth, U.S. Steel. Now it's going to be sold off like it was nothing. We're not going to let that happen. We'll build it up. We'll make it strong, but we're not going to let that happen. But with the vision I'm outlining today, not only will we stop our businesses from leaving for foreign lands, but under my leadership, we're going to take other countries' jobs. Did you ever hear that expression before? Have you ever heard that we're going to take other countries' jobs? It's never been stated before. We're going to take their factories, and we had it really rocking 4 years ago. We're going to bring thousands and thousands of businesses and trillions of dollars in wealth back to the good old USA. That's what we're going to be doing it and doing it fast. And under my plan, American workers will no longer be worried about losing your jobs to foreign nations. Instead, foreign nations will be worried about losing their jobs to America. Going to bring them back. And it won't even be difficult. Your only worry will be deciding which job to take. There will be plenty of them. That will be your biggest problem. Darling, which company should I go with? We're going to bring them back, and we're going to bring them back at levels not to be believed, but you'll believe it in about 2 years from now. You're going to say, wow, that happened fast. You're going to have so many companies wanting to come in because this is where the money is. It won't be if we keep running it like we have for the last 4 years. But this is what they want. This is what they want, and you'll hear the plan. I want German car companies to become American car companies. I want them to build their plants here. I want to beat China in electronics production, and we'll be able to do that easily. We have the greatest genius, the greatest minds here, and then we end up building them in different places. A lot of that's really stupid tax policy. I want GE, IBM, and every other manufacturer that left us to be filled with regret and come sprinting back to our shores, and they will. So as your president, here is the deal that I will be offering to every major company and manufacturer on Earth. I will give you the lowest taxes, the lowest energy costs, the lowest regulatory burden, and free access to the best and biggest market on the planet, but only if you make your product here in America. It all goes away if you don't make your product here and hire American workers for the job. If you don't make your product here, then you will have to pay a tariff, a very substantial tariff, when you send your product into the United States. And by the way, you know, for years, they knocked the word tariff, properly used, is a beautiful word. One of the most beautiful words I've ever heard. It's music to my ears. A lot of bad people didn't like that word, but now they're finding out I was right. And we will take in hundreds of billions of dollars into our treasury and use that money to benefit the American citizens. And it will not cause inflation, by the way. And, you know, I took in from China hundreds of billions of dollars in taxes and tariffs, and I had no inflation. We didn't have any inflation, 1.2%. We had essentially no inflation. Now, you've had, over the last 4 years, you've had the highest inflation, I think, in the history of our country. Somebody said, no, sir, it's only 58 years. Well, that's pretty bad, too. I think it's really in the history of our country. This is the policy that built America, and this is the policy that is going to save America, is going to save us, because we have gone so far down in so many different ways, not to mention the border, not to mention 21 million people pouring in from places unknown, totally unvetted. But like I've always called it, because it's a very beautiful and simple term, it's called America first. We're putting America first. This new American industrialism will create millions and millions of jobs, massively raise wages for American workers, and make the United States into a manufacturing powerhouse like it used to be many years ago. We will be able to build ships again. We will be able to build airplanes at a much higher level again. We will become the world leader in robotics and every other field. The U.S. auto industry, which has been decimated over many, many decades, will once again be the envy of the planet. We're not going to accept all of these cars. They come in from every country, and it knocks out. You know, I was up in Michigan. We're doing very well in Michigan. By the way, we're doing very well in Georgia. We're leading by quite a bit. But pretend you're 1 point down, please, and go and vote, okay? Don't. Just go vote. You got to vote. We got to win this. If we don't win this election, our country is gone. I really believe it. To the auto workers in Michigan, Georgia, and all other parts of our country, I am pinpointing you for greatness. Your industry has been decimated by many decades of incompetent leadership, both political and at your company level. You had presidents of your company that sold out our country. They didn't know what they were doing. They were horrible. And you had politicians that were grossly incompetent to let that happen. Your auto industry has been decimated. And again, with the electric car, it's all going to be made in China. The head of the United Auto Workers ought to be ashamed of himself for what he's done. But we're going to turn it around, and we're going to turn it around fast. China is right now building major auto plants in Mexico. Did you know that? They were going to start with me. I said, no, if you do them, I'm putting a 200% tariff on every car that comes. And they decided we'll pass. Then they said, wow, now we can build Trump. We won't have to worry about him anymore. Oh, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. We're leading in the polls. We're leading by a lot. We're leading by a lot. They said, oh, we don't have to worry about him. No, they have to worry about me. That's why they don't like me. You know, they used to like Obama. They used to like, they like Biden. You know why? Because they got away with murder. That's why they like Biden. They love Biden. Why would you like Biden except that you took advantage of him? They took advantage of him. And they think they're going to sell their cars into the United States and destroy Michigan and South Carolina and North Carolina and Georgia. And all of the places that make autos, not going to happen. We will put a 100% tariff on every single car coming across the Mexican border. And tell them the only way they'll get rid of that tariff is if they want to build a plant right here in the United States with you people operating that plant. We want American citizens, and we want their plants built here, not 2 feet over the border and selling them into our country. We're not doing that. We don't do that anymore. A friend of mine does auto plants. He builds auto plants. That's what he's great at. He's great, the biggest in the world. And I said, I want to see a plant. Pretty recently ago, I want to see a plant. Where would we go? I said, would we go to Detroit? Someplace in Michigan, ideally. He says, no, you can't go there, sir. They're not. We'll have to go to Mexico. The big ones are being built in Mexico. I said, why is that? He said, well, they have a lot of tax reasons, and China's coming in big, and they think they're going to make their car and sell it in tax-free into the United States. But the big ones, if you want to see a really big, modern plant, come with me to Mexico. I said, I'm not interested in going to Mexico. I want those plants built here. And that'll happen. In fact, when they learn about the 100 or 200% tariff, you know, they'll probably say, yeah, let's stop construction immediately. You'll see a big difference. I will bring automobile manufacturing back to the highest level in the history of our country. You know, it used to be we were the only place, and then it just got chipped away, mostly by China and Japan. And all of a sudden, we were down more than 55% from where we were years ago. But it'll be like it was 50 years ago, and these jobs, they'll become roaring back, and we're going to be making autos at a level that you've never seen before. We'll be making cars bigger, better, more beautiful, stronger, and faster than ever before. Billions of people around the globe will soon be buying products proudly stamped, made in the USA. Or if you prefer, if you have to do it, made in Georgia. You can do that. And they'll be exported through the port of Savannah. We had a little bit to do with that deeper port. Under my leadership, we helped deepen the port. You know that. We helped deepen the port once, and now I understand they want to do it again. And we will get in, and we will get that done very quickly. We'll work with you, Governor, and we're going to get that done very quickly. This will be a major undertaking involving the Army Corps of Engineers and transportation officials throughout your state. It's going to happen fast. This will happen so fast, you're going to say, gee, I thought he just said we're going to do it. You know, we have a strength over environmental impact statements. Sometimes they'll delay a project for 20 years, 25 years. With me, I think if it takes more than a month to get an approval, my people are not doing a very good job, all right? We'll get it done very quickly. With a world-class port and a world-class workforce, this city will soon become one of the premier export hubs anywhere on Earth, tripling and quadrupling traffic as your power will lead an American manufacturing boom. We're going to have a manufacturing boom, and a lot of it's just taxation policy, tariff policy. They're going to come roaring back. When they have to pay tariffs to come in, but they have incentive to build here, they're going to come roaring back. It's just, it's this. It's not muscle. It's all right there. That's a muscle, too, they say. By contrast, listen to the deal, Kamala Harris. Have you heard of her? You know, I had the first debate, and after that, Biden was down 21 points. And they went to him, and they said, you're going to lose. You can't win. You're out. This is a coup, by the way. This guy had 14 million votes. We're going to put in somebody else. The last person was going to be Kamala Harris, but then they decided to be politically correct, and she got the job. She was the last one. There were 14 people mentioned. She was number